As a child, you would wait and watch from far away. But you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream. Yourself, your spirit never dies. Farewell, I've gone to take my throne above. But don't weep for me, 'cause this will be the labor of my love.
What do you do to separate yourself from everybody else? What do I do to give myself that advantage, that edge? If everybody's out there just playing and you're exactly like them, you shape like them, you have the same speed they have, everything is the same, what's your advantage? What's your edge? To be one of the greatest athletes, to take your school's program to a level that it may have never been to, you're gonna have to have a motivation that nobody else has. You have to have a why. Your motivation has to be totally different. You have to have a why. This is all I'm asking for. I'm asking you to get a why, because apparently, there's something that's happening inside of you that does not allow you to push yourself every single time. So I'm asking you to create a why, because if you had a why, then maybe every time you went out, you just wouldn't be there in body, but you would really be there and give 120%. What are you doing for? Are you a gazelle or a lion? And I want you to stop just thinking about yourself. I want you to think about your family. I want you to think about your town. I want you to think about your school. I want you to think about yourself. Remember what we talked about. I'm going to help you to separate yourself from every other player that's the same size as you. Every other player just as quick as you. Let me tell you what I know he's not going to do. He's not going to put forth 100% effort every single play. He might do it the first quarter. He might do it the second quarter. He might even do it the third, but most of them give out in the fourth quarter and they put forth 50%. And that's why Barry Sanders was one of the best running backs that ever played the game. And he would be negative 16 yards in the third quarter and still get 100 and something in the fourth. Why? Because he said all those defensive guys, the guards, the tackle, they will get tired. Their legs will give out. And just when their legs give out is when I'm going to break for the big one. You will not outwork me. I can't help where I was born. I can't help the environment in which I was born in. I can't help that my daddy wasn't in my life, but I'm grown now. What I can do is I can outwork you every single time, because you will not wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning. And I will. And guess what? When I finish doing my work, if I'm tired, I could take a nap and I'll still get up before the next man gets up. All you have to do is be all in. On three, all in. One, two, three. One, two, three. Okay, now say it like you all in. One, two, three. Good. If you are determined to be all in every single play, you're going to catch him slipping, because he's not going to be in all in every single play. It's one thing your coach can't teach you. Help me, coaches, if I'm wrong. Coach can't teach you heart. Can you give them heart, coach? You can teach them X's and O's, all the plays. You can get them pumped up, prepare them. But heart, you can't teach a man how to be all in. He's got to do that himself. Coach can't, you the guard, center. Coach can't be like right next to you, like, all right, come on, in the game. All right, come on, go. All right, give me effort. Coach can't do that. It's illegal for him to cross that line. So listen to me very closely. When you with coach, that's wonderful. That's great, but coach don't play the game. He teach the game, he doesn't play the game. The only person that goes out there and lines up, that person is you. And if you're not all in, then you can't possibly represent yourself. You can't represent. You can't represent your community if you're not all in. I owe it to myself. Okay, I want you to say it like you mean it. I owe it to myself to give 100% every single time. I owe it to myself to give 110% every time. From this day forward, I promise to myself to be all in. No, from this day forward, come on, from this day forward, I promise to myself to be all in. Give yourselves a hand. But sometimes in life, the things that come easy won't take you where you want to go. Sometimes the easy road won't take you to where you... Sometimes it's the road less traveled that will take you to the next level. It's not always easy, but it's always rewarding. It's not always fun, but at the end of it, you are always satisfied when you make the effort. Let me tell you something. Sometimes coach gonna ask you to do stuff that you don't understand. You are 16, 17, 18. You don't have to understand. Just do what you told. Trust me, they know what they're talking about. Trust me. I want you to be comfortable being uncomfortable. As a matter of fact, I want you to embrace when it's uncomfortable. Coach, you just told me to do 50, coach. I think I might got another 20 in me, coach. Just make me do it. Just say it. Just say the word. Got it. So my final one is I want you to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, all right? How many guys want a magical season? Raise your hand. You want a magical season? Come on, talk to me. Hands high. You want a magical season? Well, if you want a magical season, you have to accept challenge. Four types of people as I leave: average, good, great, and phenomenal. Average, good, great, and phenomenal. Be phenomenal or be forgotten.
The Spartans of Michigan State University, an unwavering belief in one another. And oh yeah, the number
a company
in the nation.
Always on the run. A destiny. Oh, it's the rising sun. I was born a shotgun in my hands. Behind the gun, I'll make my final stand. deserters we've been called. Chose a gun and threw away the sun. Oh. Now these towns, well, they all know our name. The death punch sound is our claim to fame. And that's why they call me Bad Company. I can't deny
to go into the semifinal game against a fine Carlsbad team tonight. Watch over and protect both teams. Now the good news is last year they were juniors and we could come back and finish it. Men, they ain't juniors anymore. You are facing the toughest opponent that you will face this year, tonight. Tonight, not next week. There will be no next week unless you start believing that you've got to play your best game tonight. I hope you're not content in being in the semifinals. I hope there is a burning desire in each and every one of you for that special experience that only takes place at Jack Murphy Stadium. Now you guys may think that we always go there because we've been there 2 years in a row. It ain't like that. It's special. People don't just go there. It's special. And you've got to have a fire in your belly that tells you I want to be there in the worst way. You can't be quiet. You can't be unemotional. This is an emotional game. An emotional game. And we got to have it from the heart. We got to play with heart tonight, guys. Now, you guys all understand what last play means? Last play. You play every play as if it was the last play you will ever play. And if we don't play with emotion, if we don't play the last play on every play, it will be. There won't be a next week. Every play tonight, you play, you think about what that means. You think about what it means to be on your last play. This is my last play of football ever. My last play, how do I want it to be? How do I want to be remembered? My last play. Every play. Last play on three. 1, 2, 3.
Last play. Last play. Last play. Last play.
Let's go play it. How do I want to be remembered? My life!